Working Interferences is intended for mature audiences. Since the hosts never grew up, someone needs to be the adult.
Welcome to Working Interferences with Lance
and Holly,
the dental advice podcast for the average dentist. Here is Lance
and Holly. All right, well, welcome back. It's actually a different co-host this week because it is not Holly, but I'm welcoming back. I am Lance Timmerman. I'm welcoming back my daughter, Bianca.
Hello.
Bianca, actually, you were on an episode before, weren't you?
I was. We talked about Botox.
Botox. Okay. All right. We actually have had people say, hey, when's Bianca coming back?
Oh, really?
So now the answer is now, right now, this
right
very
now,
moment.
And we are not going to be talking about anything related to dentistry.
Well, no,
anything medical.
Sort of. I mean, because it gets indirectly.
Okay.
You're mostly right, but there is an indirect thing. So, Bianca, last time we talked, you worked in a med spa.
Correct.
And that's why we were talking about Botox, the way that the fee structure was in all that. You've moved on.
I have.
So tell us, where are you now?
I now work at a waxing salon. Mm-hmm. So I'm actually doing something with my license, because mm-hmm. when I worked at the med spa, I was kind of just a glorified receptionist. I wasn't really an esthetician. I was because when you go to a med spa, you don't really go for your basic aesthetic needs. You go for something more. That's why you go to a med spa. So you go to a med spa for like a chemical peel or microneedling or something more intense that I can't do with my with my license.
Did you know that when you got the job?
I did, because I took the job more as a favor from a friend.
Oh.
Rather than like, oh, I really want to work at a med spa. I never really had any interest in working at a med spa. I just did it because I got fired from the first wax center that I worked at. And my friend texted me and she goes, hey, I heard something happened.
Okay.
We have an opening at my med spa that I'm working at if you are interested in like taking up a part-time job. And I was just like just desperate, honestly. And
okay. So when you got fired, was it a justified firing, or was it just the way that particular place?
They did not like my personality.
To be fair.
To be fair, I am an asshole, and it was in Kirkland.
You're my daughter, and so
they didn't like my personality, and they didn't like the fact that I didn't take notes, even though I told them like they mostly said it was because they didn't take notes, even though I told them multiple times that I don't take notes. That's not how I learn. Because if I take notes, then I'm focusing on taking notes, I'm not taking in the information that I'm learning.
So that's the way I was in school, is I really didn't take notes much. I'd take notes occasionally, mm-hmm. but for the most part, I was so hyper-focused that mm-hmm. I learned the material from reading it or learning it and that kind of thing. So we're on the same page.
Yeah, like I didn't take a single note in aesthetic school. It scared the shit out of my teacher, because I would just be sitting there with my arms crossed, mm-hmm. no pen or pencil, no paper in front of me.
Kind of creepy.
I would just be staring her down.
Been there.
And there were
definitely my daughter.
There were many times where she like would stop mid sentence in her lecture and she'd be like, B, is everything okay? And I'm just like, oh yeah, I'm fine. And she goes, okay, I thought I felt like I was doing something wrong.
Yeah, you're kind of creepy.
And I'm just like, you're the teacher. You would know if you're doing something wrong. But whatever, it's fine.
So you've been, since you've had this job, mm-hmm. You've had some things that have come up that I'm like, man, this is actually perfect for a podcast.
Okay.
And so that's why I said, you know what, we should really record this. Or you come home and vent, I'm like, oh, I should be recording this. because I think it's good from most of our listeners. If it doesn't relate specifically to a dental office, we're all consumers. Mm-hmm. And so for those that don't know, I think most do, we're in the United States. We're in Seattle, Washington. So mm-hmm. we're in the northwest of the United States. And most of my listeners in the United States, but I have listeners from all over. I'm really big in Trinidad and Tobago.
Wow. Look at you.
At least I used to be. Okay. I haven't looked at the stats for a while.
We're big in Belgium.
That's a singles reference. So in America, what's interesting about America is...
What's stupid about
what's
America?
Dumb. And let's be honest. We're both on the same page. I think the tipping culture is dumb. I love when I go to Europe because mm-hmm. you don't tip.
Yeah. Whenever I complain about tipping, I always Okay, so I make TikToks, and it does really well because I make like Karen TikToks where I just kind of like I'll do like a little skit essentially of me like reenacting like an experience with a Karen.
Okay.
And more often than not, like it's a part of the reason why I don't like that person is like, oh, I know that they're not going to tip very well.
Okay.
And because TikTok will not just show your videos to people who are nearby you, it shows globally.
Okay.
Depending on who likes what stuff. Yeah.
There's some algorithm that connects them to us.
So I get a lot of people who are, you know, not from America, and they'll comment and they'll be like, they'll give their 2 cents on, you know, tipping culture, but it comes from a very, oh, you don't know. You're saying things that make sense and they make sense to you, but they don't matter. They don't matter. They don't do anything. And two, you're just talking to a wall.
Yeah. Yeah. So I want to back up a little bit. So you have, I'm your dad. I'm a dad. I don't do TikTok. I don't really know much about it. I probably should, but don't. You have a following. You've got how many followers now?
26.6K.
Jesus. Last time we talked, I said, oh, 10,000. You said, no, it's 12. And then the day later, I'm like, yeah, you had 12,000. No, I'm up to 14 now. Last I heard was 14. So now you're up to 26,500.
Yeah.
Okay.
The Karen videos do well.
That's the thing is, it makes sense that the blasting Karens would do such.
Yeah, because it's a universal thing. Everywhere has
we all hate Karens.
Everywhere has a Karen experience.
And to be fair, I know several Karens. I used to post Karen memes. I pretty much all I do with Instagram and Facebook is I post memes.
Right.
And for a while, there just was a bunch of Karen memes, and I had a friend named Karen, kind of take it personally. I think it was tongue in cheek, but she was like, hey, enough with this freaking Karen shit.
The world does not revolve around you. Shut the fuck up. Well,
I can understand. I did the math. I'm like, yeah, I am kind of going overboard with Karen specifically stuff. So I toned it down a little bit, but
unfortunately that's just the universal name for them.
Yeah.
There's nothing you can really do about that. Sorry. Yeah. If the shoe doesn't fit, don't try to make it wear it. Like, well, don't try to force yourself to wear it.
At the same token, if you're not an asshole, you got nothing to worry about.
Exactly.
you just happen to be named Karen.
That's another thing that, like, sometimes I'll get comments from people who are like, well, I don't act that way. Okay, then clearly I'm not talking about you.
Yeah. Yeah, you're good. You're good.
Yeah, clearly I'm not making fun of you. If you don't act the way that I am making fun of, clearly I'm not talking about you.
Yeah. Yeah. So lately, what's been very, very interesting is there is a little bit of a push right now in America, for those not in America, that we are actually kind of trying to fight back against the tip culture. Mm-hmm. Because we have a lot of people that are paid minimum. Actually, a lot of places are paid less than minimum wage because it's assumed you're going to make a tip.
Yeah. I know a lot of people who are waiters and waitresses. They literally get paid a $2 hourly because they're expected to make really good tips.
And I don't think that should be legal.
I think that's absolutely fucking stupid.
$2 an hour is just dumb. It should be minimum wage.
Yeah.
Minimum.
That's slave labor.
That's the word minimum means.
Yeah.
So how do they get away with that?
I don't know. I really don't know. I've never been a waiter.
Because I don't pay minimum wage, so I don't even know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So something that bothers me is I make slightly over minimum wage.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. What is the minimum wage in Washington? 15?
Well, Seattle is $15 an hour. Okay. Outside of Seattle, I think it's like 12.
Okay. Because so I make $16.75.
Okay. Which is a decent wage when you're living at home.
Yes. Thank God I am.
Yeah. So, and I love to see you every night when I come home, all that kind of stuff. Happy you're here.
Thank you.
But I agree, that's not enough.
Yeah.
It's enough for right now, but how long? Is it sustainable?
No.
Not real. No, it really isn't.
But to get out of the way, yes, I think that tipping culture is fucking stupid.
Mm-hmm.
I think that my employer should be paying me a good hourly.
Mm-hmm. Big fan of the South Park guys. The guys that do South Park, they own a restaurant, and they eliminated tips. They said tips are not allowed in their restaurant, but they paid everybody $30 an hour.
Yeah.
You know what? That's actually, I'm a big fan.
Yeah. It makes sense, but it's a matter of, like, I don't agree with it. I don't like it. I understand people's frustrations with tipping culture.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, there's nothing that I can do about it.
Right. So what do you say to the person that says, you know what, I don't believe in tipping?
Why? It's not something that you believe in. It's that's not.
It's not a belief.
No, that's so stupid.
Oh, I go to a different church.
I don't believe in. I don't believe in tipping. How long have you been in America?
Are you American?
Yeah. Well, that's another thing that bothers me is that some people will be like, "Oh, we don't tip in my culture," but they've been my client for 8 months, uh-huh. And I'm just like, "Okay, so this is your culture now.
You're an American now, bitch."
That's my thing. I'm like, okay, if you're a foreigner who just decided to like stop by and get a wax, and I only see you one time,
mm-hmm.
Fine, don't tip me. It's not a part of your culture. Fine, I'm never seeing you again.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're a regular client of mine and mm-hmm. I see you consistently for like a year, and you're constantly being like, "Oh, it's not my culture to tip." Yes, the fuck it is.
Yeah.
You're in America. You live in America.
You're American now, bitch.
You've probably been in America plenty
long
of
enough.
Time. You were probably here before you were my client.
Uh-huh.
Now you're just using it as an excuse to be a dick.
Mm-hmm.
But,
okay, so one thing I was interested in, you're in a place that is, they're hyper-focused on speed.
Yes.
Okay. So they wax, what's the typical appointment in your place?
The typical appointment is 15 minutes.
Okay.
So if you come in just for one thing, mm-hmm. the minimum amount of time that they can schedule with me is for 15 minutes.
Okay.
I think it's stupid, but you know, it's what I do. And okay. I've been working there for a year and a half now, so I'm used to it.
Okay.
Now
that's the minimum, but what is your average? Are a lot of people buying extra things so it ends up being a half hour, 45 minutes?
No.
Okay.
So, okay, the way that where I work works is that the more, if you get promoted, you get less time.
That sounds like punishment.
I know. Yeah, you get less time, but you get a 25 cent raise.
Oh, well then, okay, that makes sense.
Right, yeah, exactly. Cool. It's a whole 25 cents.
Jesus Christ.
So fucking stupid. Oh yeah, and don't forget the 5% commission.
Okay, so you are paid on a commission. You get a minimum hourly and a commission.
And tips. But if I get electronic tips, those electronic tips get taxed in my paycheck. I have no idea the percentage of the tax.
So electronic meaning they use a credit card to pay for their balance?
Yes.
And so then they added the tip to it?
Correct.
But so it's better if they were just to pay cash. So this is a lesson to those that just...
If you feel free to pay for the service with card, but just tip in cash.
Tip with cash.
I have a lot of people who pay on card, but they'll hand me like a $20 bill or a $10 bill and be like, "This is your tip." And I'll be like, "Thank you so much." And I actually really like cash tips because I tend to forget about them.
Mm-hmm.
And they end up just adding up over time, and all of a sudden I'm rich, and it's wonderful.
You have a wad of cash in the bedroom.
Yeah, I literally have a bag. Nice. It's wonderful.
Okay.
I have a Ziploc bag.
Is it underneath your mattress?
Should be, probably.
Okay, I just want to know where to look.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. When I short some cash, I just want to know.
Awesome.
Yeah. So... What should people, what do you think people should be tipping?
I think that a 20% tip.
Okay.
I think people should tip based off of percentage.
Okay.
Rather than just thinking that a certain amount is going to be enough, because the cost of the service changes what the percentage of the tip is. So if you are tipping me $20 on a Brazilian, that's a great tip on a Brazilian.
How much is a Brazilian?
86. Where I am, it's $86.
Okay.
Other states, it's like $50, $56,
oh, really?
$60, because Seattle's so expensive, they can charge more.
I've never had a Brazilian, so I don't know.
Right.
And just so you know, you're safe. I will never ask you for
Thank
a Brazilian.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
There's only so much therapy that can be done.
Right. Exactly. But I think people should tip based off of like percentage.
Okay.
Because I had somebody, more often than not, people think that a universal like good tip on mm-hmm. a wax is $10. It's not.
Okay.
I don't even like getting a $10 tip on a Brazilian.
Okay. Well, and how much should a Brazilian, so 86 is what you said?
Yeah.
So it should be like $16?
Yeah. So
if it was 20.
I do get a lot of people who give me a $16 tip and I'm just like, okay, they just did percentage.
Yeah.
I can tell.
Okay.
Whenever the tip is just like a set dollar amount, and like there's just like the 00 cents.
Uh-huh.
That's how I know that they told them like a dollar amount that they wanted to tip them. Okay. If it's like 16.25, then that's how I know that they're gonna do like a percentage.
They just okay.
But I
like
had,
on the receipts, does it say like 15% is this much, 18% is this
so
much?
It's not like that. It doesn't come up on their end.
Okay.
They tell the person at the front desk how much they want to tip them.
Okay.
So.
Oh, okay. So they're telling, hey, just make it 20% and they make it 15%. And so then the person at the cash register clicks the button and that's what it ends up. Okay.
Yeah. And so like. A lot of the people at the front desk will be like, oh, would you like to leave a 15% tip? Oh, would you like to leave a 20% gratuity?
Okay.
Or they'll just say, how much of a gratuity would you like to leave your specialist?
Okay.
When you say that, when you don't say a specific percentage, they're more likely to give a low tip.
Mm-hmm.
So I actually... And also another thing that I have noticed is that the larger the service, the smaller the tip is going to be.
Okay.
Because like I said, people think that a $10 tip is a universal good tip.
Gotcha.
But like I said,
so how long does a Brazilian take?
15 minutes.
Oh, really? I would have thought it would be longer.
Mm-mm.
So, but you'll have people do Brazilian and other things too. So suddenly, how long is the longest appointment that you've done?
The longest appointment that I have done is 2.5 hours. And okay. I got a $10 tip on it.
Okay, so that's bullshit.
That's what I'm saying. When I complain about tipping, I'm not complaining about the person who's giving me a $5 tip on a Brazilian or a $10 tip on a Brazilian. I'm complaining about the people who give me a $10 tip on a service that ended up being over $200. Because I'm just like, if you have no issue paying for 7 services and then getting product on top of that, and then you're going to lowball the tip... That's where I'm just like, okay, so you're just an asshole.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because you can afford all of this. If we took away all of the products that you're purchasing, you could be spending, you could use the money that you're spending on those products to tip me.
Mm-hmm.
But instead, you're choosing to pay for those products, which is just going to the company that I work for, not me.
Right, right.
It's going to the company that I work for who doesn't do fucking shit.
Do I need to bleep that out?
Probably.
Okay. I probably won't. I'm pretty lazy lately, so
that's okay. I'm all not right, bleeping. Whatever. That's fine. I'll just get fired.
Okay, I'll bleep for you then. I'll just remember 17 minutes in, I'll go in. And,
appreciate.
Okay.
But it's I get a lot of comments from people who are just like, well, we already pay for the service. Why do we have to pay for the tip? Because I don't get the money from the service.
Yeah, the service is nothing to do with you.
The service is paying for the product that I'm using on you, and it's paying my employer to keep the place afloat.
Right, right.
It's not paying me. I'm getting 5% of that $86 Brazilian.
Right. But if you were in Argentina, you might see it differently. How would an Argentinian person see it?
Oh my God.
Because you.
This is very specific. So, there's a reason why this is specific.
So TikTok will allow you to see who's making the comment and if they put a flag. We had to do fun with flags because we had to look up what is this? I know Argentina's flag, but it was so small I couldn't tell the colors.
It was the emoji.
Yeah, those emojis. Don't always tell you everything.
Especially since I don't have like my text size on my phone.
It was really small.
It's pretty small compared to yours.
Wait.
Yeah. Just let it resonate with you.
Yes, I do have the setting at the highest size. So those that don't know, as you get older, your vision gets worse and you need bigger fonts.
Yeah.
So
I don't even really fucking know. It's gotten to a point where I don't really respond to comments anymore.
Well, what's cool is you've got people that defend you
I've gotten videos to do well enough that I can just allow keyboard warriors to do the fighting for me.
That's awesome.
Which is so nice and
I'm so jealous.
And very entertaining because I will watch on the sidelines. And also, if you don't know, on TikTok, if you created the video and you like a comment, it will say liked by creator. And so every single time that there is a comment in like a comment thread where people are like arguing back and forth and there's one person that I do agree with, I will like their comment and it will show liked by creator every time.
Okay.
So they know that they are fighting a losing battle.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Okay. That's interesting.
But, so I had somebody who was like, hey, I've never gotten waxed before. How much should I tip? Mm-hmm. It was literally just that comment.
Okay.
And then somebody was like, well, you're already paying for the service. Why would you have to tip? They're just doing their job.
And where was this person from?
Argentina.
Okay.
And this person was like, well, they said something along the lines of, well, I've been working since I was 18 and I'm 19 now. And I work as a hotel receptionist.
I know everything.
So I understand the working world. I understand. I understand like how nice it is to get a tip, but I also understand that it's not a necessity. And I'm like, bitch, you've been in the working world for a whole year, maybe a year and a half.
In Argentina,
where they pay you well enough. You don't work a tip dependent job. Nobody anywhere tips a hotel receptionist.
Yeah, I stayed at a hotel Friday night. I didn't tip them. Yeah. You know why?
Because
we don't do that.
Because you don't have to.
And this is a tipping culture.
It's not expected.
We don't tip the hotel.
It's not even expected in America to tip the hotel receptionist. My thing is, if you are upset about tipping culture, complain about tipping like the crumble cookie kiosk where you're tipping a robot. You're not.
Yeah, that's bullshit.
You're not getting a service. You're not being serviced. You're not tipping somebody for a service. You're tipping a literal robot.
Yeah, I'm not tipping the ATM. All that kind of stuff.
Absolutely.
If there's
not.
No human involved, there's no tip.
Yeah. However, if you're gonna ask me to get up all up in your business,
when you say business, I mean
your literal vagina and your butthole, or your penis and your butthole, because I do all of it. Mm.
Sounds terrible.
I shouldn't be called an asshole for expecting a tip.
If you're waxing the asshole, you're not the asshole.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I am saying. I think tipping culture is stupid.
It is stupid.
I think my employer should tip me a fair wage. However, I have asked for a raise, and I know people at my work who have asked for a raise and have gotten fired for asking for a raise. I have asked for a raise. The best that they could do was a 25-cent raise. I asked for a raise and I was like, you know, I don't think that I should be making just like a little over minimum wage. And they're like, well, technically you don't make minimum wage with tips and commission. And I'm like, well, fun fact, tips and commission aren't fucking guaranteed.
Yeah.
For example, if somebody no-shows that I lose that money from that potential service and there's not enough time to replace the service time.
Right.
So I lose that money entirely. The company also loses that money. So I don't know why they're okay with that.
Mm-hmm.
But if like I said, I had a 2.5 hour service and I got a $10 tip. I didn't make more than
minimum wage or your minimum. Yeah.
Yeah. So whenever they're like, oh, you know, you technically make more, like you technically make $30-$35 an hour.
So 2.5 hours, how many services were done in that? Was that like 10 services?
No, it was a Brazilian, a full leg, a full arm, an underarm, a stomach strip, a full butt, and an upper lip.
So you would have been better off to say,
seven services?
Mrs. Jones, you can only schedule 2 services at a time.
Yeah.
Because then you could have the next person, because you're only going to get 10 bucks each. I'd rather see 7 people.
Absolutely.
10 bucks each instead of one person.
Exactly. That was the thing that was really bothering me. As well, like in that 2.5 hours, I could have seen 10. I could have literally seen 10 people.
Okay.
Gotten a $10. I could have gotten a fucking $5 tip from each person, and I would have made significantly more than I did from the 2.5 hour service. But the frustrating thing is that the company that I work for want me to have those big services.
Yeah.
Because it helps my SPT, which means service per ticket. So it's like the amount of services that I'm doing per appointment.
Uh-huh.
They want me to do that. They want me to add that on. However, I don't want to do that because I have noticed that the more services that people are getting in one appointment time, the smaller my tip is going to be, which means I'm getting paid less money.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think tip culture is fucking stupid because I suffer from it.
Yeah.
I don't benefit from tipping culture. I really don't.
No.
people, I don't know a single person who is dependent on tips who likes being dependent on tips. I don't know. I don't understand why people get mad at the person who is dependent on tips for wanting a tip.
I hear the where I hear people liking tips are the people that are servers in the really high end restaurants.
At luxury restaurants.
Yes. That's the only people I hear.
But that's
good.
Because the people who can go to those
yes.
restaurants are the filthy rich.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's not. And that's another thing that bothers me. People tend to think that what I do is essential.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They're like,
I mean, hairy buttholes are bad.
I did get a comment from somebody who was just like, what? So poor people can't have nice things.
Oh my God.
Correct, shoddy. Like the fuck do you want me to do? If you can't afford,
I'm not donating a waxed butthole.
If you can't afford to get a Brazilian wax, shave. It's like you're not complaining to Gucci and Chanel for their crazy prices because the common person can't afford it. You need to lower your prices so I can afford it. No, you just don't have Gucci or Chanel. What I do is technically a luxury service.
Sure.
It's not essential.
Right.
You're not required to get it.
Mm-hmm.
You're not entitled to it.
Right.
So if you are setting aside, if you do not make a lot of money and you decide that this is something that you that is important to you mm-hmm. and that you need,
uh-huh.
you are going to save up for it. It's like a tattoo. You save up for it. You put money aside for it.
Right.
When you are saving up for your Brazilian,
mm-hmm.
you should be also saving up for the tip.
Yeah.
That it's like, it was funny when I got that comment because they were like, what? So poor people can't have nice things. The person who responded said, correct. It wasn't even me who said it.
Yeah. Yeah. And well, I mean, it's like poor people don't get a Ferrari.
Yes.
Correct.
That's exactly the point. Ferraris are not for the poor.
You get an Audi. I don't know what's a cheap car.
Yeah. Audi's actually an electric car too.
Fuck. I don't know.
it's a nice car.
I'm not a car person, but like.
Toyota. Just say Toyota.
Right. Okay.
I mean, and there's some really nice Toyotas and there's Prius? Entry level. Priuses are in high demand right now because everybody wants to go green.
Okay.
So,
well, I don't know.
But
see,
even like a Kia, we used to make fun of Kia. Kia now has some really nice mm-hmm. brands, but they have entry level ones as well. Mm-hmm. There's no entry level Ferrari. Well, there is. There's a lower level Ferrari. It's still a couple hundred thousand dollars.
Yeah.
The poors don't buy them.
But yeah, it's kind of like, what? Like, oh, poor people can't have a Tesla? If you can't afford it, no.
I mean, probably not. Yeah.
If you can't afford it. Like, you have to be. I'm pretty sure you have to have a credit check just to test drive a Tesla.
Do they really?
I'm pretty sure.
No,
like,
I've never test driven one.
Like, I'm pretty sure they're like.
I have friends with them. I've ridden, but.
I'm pretty sure it's been like a. I might be wrong,
yeah.
But last time I was talking to somebody about this, they were like, oh yeah, I one time went to like a Tesla dealership because I wanted to just drive one around. I wasn't even going to buy one. And mm-hmm. they refused because they did a credit check on me, saw that I wasn't going to make them a
couldn't.
Sale.
Yeah.
Wasn't going to make them a sale, so they didn't allow me to.
That makes sense.
It does make sense. It could you argue that it's stupid? Sure.
Maybe.
But also, the person who works at that Tesla dealership probably makes commission.
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense. I mean, I probably contributed to that because I told you my 16th birthday.
You did tell me that.
Okay. Or no, it was my 18th birthday. Where, for listeners, I was driving a Honda and I was in high school on my birthday. So this is 1988. And I grew up in Kirkland before. Kirkland is now known as kind of an affluent neighborhood suburb of Seattle. Back in the day, it wasn't. But Bellevue was. And Bellevue is where I had my car getting serviced. So my friend Dana was driving me after high school, after the day ended in high school. We got out at 2:30 in the afternoon. And she's driving me to Bellevue to go pick up my car. And we still had some time to kill. So a bunch of people give me some gifts. And I had some balloons in the backseat of her car. And so we drove up. And some guy came out to saw this. And he says, hey, I see balloons. Is it someone's birthday? So I popped out of the car. I'm like, yeah, Daddy said pick out a car. So I want.
So it's probably to avoid that.
Yeah, I test drove a little Volkswagen Cabriolet. Dana and I drove around and just screwed around and everything and came back and then the guy's like, "What'd you think? Can I get a brochure for Daddy?" And he gave me a brochure and we went and picked up my Honda and I drove home and Never saw him again.
Right.
So I'm the asshole that made them have the policy not to just give people keys.
You're welcome. Courtesy of my father. But that's just my thing is I'm just like, I don't do something that is essential. Like what I do isn't a convenience thing. It's not a drive through. It's convenient because it's quick.
Mm-hmm.
But the service itself is not essential.
Yeah.
Like I get a lot of people who get waxed during their lunch break because it's that quick.
Okay. Now you also have an interesting policy. So those that are the dental listeners, both of you, you have a unique policy. I kind of love you. If person is 5 minutes late, you'll still see them.
Yes.
Okay. But there's a drop dead, get out of my life time.
We have a 9 minute grace period.
9 minute grace period.
So if you,
if you have a 15 minute appointment,
it's stupid. Cause then I get 6 minutes to do the service. However, for some dumb fucking reason, if you check in at 9 minutes, and then use the restroom for 2 minutes, I still am required to take you.
Yeah, that's got to change.
Which throws off my entire... I think it should be a 5 minute cutoff.
Yeah.
Because I can do a Brazilian in 10 minutes. That's
really.
If I I'll be like I just won't tweeze, so you might have a few hairs left behind, but I can do my strips and get you pretty clean.
Okay.
But because I'm so limited on time, every fucking minute counts.
Okay.
And it's so weird because I was like talking about, you know, how much I don't like it when people are late because it throws off my day because my ego is too big to like cut off the appointment when the appointment's supposed to end because I so badly want people to come back to me.
Oh, see, that's why we differ.
That is where we differ.
Because I hope people they'll
in
never
time.
Come back. Yeah, you'll get there.
In time, eventually, I will eventually, you know, not give a shit and just be like, oh, sorry, that was all I could do. I could only do 2 strips because
you were late.
You
asshole.
You spent 4 minutes in the bathroom.
Yeah.
You clogged your toilet. Like,
yeah. We've had that happen too.
Yeah. But it's like...
We're drawing straws. Who has to go unplug the toilet?
Yeah.
I always lose.
But like sometimes like people will spend a long time in the bath. They'll show up late because they know that they can get away with it.
Mm-hmm.
Then they will go into the bathroom and they will take a fat shit or whatever. And they'll come into my room and they'll be like, oh, make sure that you get every single hair. I'm going on a date tomorrow.
Oh,
and I'm like, sorry, babe. I have 3 minutes.
Yeah.
So wish me the fuck luck.
Yeah.
Grip the table. I'm not going to give you any fucking downtime. I'm going to lay down that strip and then immediately yank it off. There's no 1-2 pull. I'm just going to go for it. Like, I will do the best that I possibly can.
Yeah.
But when people show up late, I had another person comment. I have a lot of comments. I had somebody comment. They were just like, well, that makes no sense because they can do whatever the hell they want with their appointment time, with their paid for time. Fun fact, it's not paid for until you pay for it, and you don't pay for it until you leave. So,
yeah.
In reality, they're just wasting my time for free.
Yeah.
Second of all, no, the fuck they can't. It's not their paid for time. It's the time that they're paying. It's my time they're paying for.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are booked with me for 15 minutes, that is my 15 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You book when I'm available, not the other way around.
Right.
So whenever people have this weird high and mighty like entitlement where they're just like, well, it's my appointment. No, it's my appointment.
Mm-hmm.
You're in my room. You're in my bed. You are getting waxed by me.
Uh-huh.
I'm the one in control here.
I agree.
So, fuck you for showing up late knowing you can get away with it.
Uh-huh.
And then using your sweet-ass time in the fucking bathroom, going to the gym before your appointment and not showering prior. So, you're just sweaty as fuck. So, I'm just like... Why would you expect me to like you and respect you if you so clearly do not respect me back?
Yeah.
I'm not somebody that you can like spit on and be like, clean it. Like, no.
Right.
I am a luxury service provider.
Right. For sure.
Treat me as such.
Yeah. I have the enviable position of I've been doing this for, you know, coming up on 30 years.
Mm-hmm.
And so I kick people out of the practice. Yeah. People show up late. My rules. Oh, then I'm not going to see you, kick you out of the, I mean, I can do that. You can't. You're not the boss. So absolutely, you're stuck.
Correct. However, I have grown a backbone.
Nice.
Quite a bit since I've started working there.
Cool.
Because I used to let people just walk all over me. Now I actually, I actually threatened somebody.
Oh, see, that sounds illegal.
So somebody, well, technically it wasn't.
Okay.
So somebody was being rude to the front desk associate who was 16. So I'm very protective of my front desk associates because there are a lot of people who are a lot nicer to the service provider than they are the receptionist.
Yes. And that's kind of in the dental world as well.
It's kind of universe.
They respect me, but they treat my staff like shit.
They respect the person who handles their food, but not the person who serves the food kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Like, so this woman was being so rude to this 16-year-old receptionist. And I didn't know that she was being rude to her until she was back in the room, basically gloating about being rude to her.
Really?
Like she felt proud of it.
Oh.
Which is so pathetic.
Yeah.
Like if you, as a grown adult, feel good about being rude to a literal child, you are pathetic.
Yeah, you're kind of a piece of shit.
And this woman, she's like talking to me and she's just like, oh my God, that little bitch up at the front. The little bitch up at the front told her about the 9-minute policy.
Yeah.
Because the woman was 6 minutes late. And if you are at all and like any minute late to your appointment, they will just say, just letting you know for future reference, we do have a 9-minute grace period. So we do prefer you to show up a little early for your appointment so that you can use the restroom, wait, get a drink of water, do whatever you have to do. It's better to be showing up early or on time than it is to be late. So
Absolutely. That's
all that this girl was telling this woman about. She was just telling her.
It's like a life lesson.
Yeah.
Jesus.
She's just like, hey, just heads up. Like next time we do have a 9-minute grace period. So we do prefer you to show up a little bit earlier. So this woman was just being like, oh, that bitch at the front. She was telling me all about the 9-minute grace period. I know about the 9-minute. Like, I've been going here for so long. You don't think I know about it? Like, she was just, I don't even remember all that she was saying. She was just being an asshole. It's been so long. I don't even really remember what she was saying to me because she did make a comment to me. So I decided to take the initiative. So when I do a Brazilian, I lay down 3 strips at a time.
Okay.
I lay a strip on the labia, an inner thigh piece, and one on like the top part.
Okay.
Because I get a majority of the hair out of the way within the first 6 strips. So I lay down 3 strips at a time.
Okay.
So that by the time I remove those 3 strips, we're already halfway done the bad part. It makes it quick and it makes it not as traumatizing for the client, whatever. So I lay down those 3 strips and I look at her and I took off my gloves and I said, I have the right to refuse service at any point in time. Are you going to start treating the people here like human beings or are you going to take those off yourself?
Oh God.
And she was like, what? And I was like, cause I'm telling you, I've done my own Brazilian before. It's really not that fun.
Nice.
And she was like, how could you speak to me like this? Like I'm paying for the service. I was like, yeah, but you haven't paid for it yet.
Yeah. So at this point,
and if I don't do the service, I'm not going to charge you for it.
Yeah.
It's up to you.
Yeah. But you're being an ass to the little girl up front.
I was like, but you will not speak to me or my coworkers like this. So your choice. Am I putting my gloves back on or are you taking those off yourself?
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, I can't take them off myself. And I was like, oh, you can. I've done it before.
You won't like it.
It's just going to take a little while because it's really hard to mentally prepare yourself to inflict that kind of pain on yourself.
It is not fun.
Mm-hmm.
And I just mean other things because I've never done that.
And I was just like, but you will not speak to me like this. You will not speak to my coworkers like this. So it's up to you. Am I refusing service or are you going to treat us like we're human beings? And she's like, well, I guess I'll just stop. And I was like, we're going to stop the service? And she goes, no, I'll just stop talking. And I was like, perfect. And I put my gloves back on and I yanked them off. She was quiet the entire service. I haven't seen her since, but I don't want to.
As I say, you know, yeah, it's perfect. It's a win-win. You got rid of her. She's never coming back. Awesome.
Awesome. But she then like mumbled an apology because I walked her up to the front at the end of the service and I was like, and she's going to get you all checked out. And I stayed up at the front while she was checking out and I just like stared her down to make sure that she wasn't going to be an asshole to her.
Yeah.
And she just like would not make eye contact with either of us.
Good.
And I was just like, you have clearly never been told no in your life. Give me a 20% gratuity. Yeah, yeah.
I want 20%.
I want 20%.
I want 30.
Honestly, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, it's also so funny because I did make a... Sometimes at where I work, there are three different services. Like there's a Brazilian with no butt strip. There's a Brazilian. And then there's the bikini line.
Butt strip? Well,
So a Brazilian takes care of everything off the front.
Okay.
And then a little bit off the back.
Okay.
So it takes the hair that's on your butthole.
Okay. Would that be the perineum?
Sure.
Okay.
So that's a full Brazilian. It includes a little bit off the back and then everything off the front. Or okay. as much as you want off the front, I guess, I should say. Because sometimes people will leave like a triangle or a landing strip or whatever.
Okay.
But the difference between the Brazilian with no butt strip and the full Brazilian is a $20 difference.
Okay.
And so I said that in a video one time and I kept getting a bunch of comments where just like $20 for a butt strip. That's incredibly expensive. That's crazy. That's insane. And I just always respond with, how much would you personally charge to wax a stranger's butthole? Like, for example, you, how much would you charge specifically to...
So much more than $20.
Exactly. Like when, like if you think about it...
I'm on the other hole and it's still not enough.
Yeah. If you really think about the service that you're getting and the service that you are asking somebody else to do for you, that puts it in a completely different perspective than just like reading the words on the screen.
Yeah.
Because you see a Brazilian and you see it for $80 and you're just like, oh my God, that's insane. Okay. How much would you personally charge to get up all into somebody's business and make sure that there is not a single hair left behind?
Because so much more.
Because I promise you, you're probably going to charge somebody, a stranger that you've never met. You're literally saying, hello, nice to meet you. Drop your pants. You would most likely charge. I actually asked a few of my friends. And I was just like, you know, like, how much would you charge? Every single one of them gave me a number higher than 150.
Yeah. I think it's, $20 is a bargain, people.
Absolutely.
Still not paying you to do it.
Like a $60 Brazilian with no butt strip or an $80 full Brazilian.
Yeah.
That's kind of a steal, not going to lie.
Yeah.
And well, so whenever, totally agree. But every single time that I get a comment where they're just like, oh, $20, that's insane. And I say, well, how much would you charge? I never get a response back. Nobody ever responds to that because they know that they personally would charge more for it.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, that's some crazy shit.
It's fucking stupid.
So you've had quite the last couple of weeks. Your TikTok comments have been very, very interesting.
Oh yeah,
and I've enjoyed
hearing about them.
Hearing everything. That's why I said, man, we really got to record this shit. Is there anything else that you really want to get off your chest about all that? And you don't have to. We've covered quite a bit.
You know what's interesting? It's weird whenever people hear that I do a Brazilian in 15 minutes and they're like, oh, well, my girl books out for an hour for a Brazilian. And I'm just like, so you're paying to get tortured for an hour. Cool. What about it? And they're like, well, no, she's just thorough. And I was like, I'm fucking thorough.
Yeah.
Like, what does that have to do with anything? How are you going to insult me on my abilities to do my job when you have never had me service you?
Well, what's interesting, so kind of a similar thing. I've been doing dentistry for so long that I've learned ways to be very efficient. And so recently I worked at another clinic and they block out 2 hours to do a crown. And I can typically, if people are compliant and they get numb quick enough and they're on time, all kind of stuff, I can be done in like 30 minutes.
Yeah. If everything goes according to plan.
And I can't promise that every single time. It might end up being more like 45 minutes.
Yeah.
But I've never, it's been years since it's been an hour and a half to 2 hours. Mm-hmm. And I was telling another dentist that, and he's like, oh, well, I'm just really, careful. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, wait, so you're saying I'm sloppy?
Yeah. Oh my God.
And
yeah.
They're like, well, no, I'm really concerned about quality. I said, so you're saying I don't care about quality.
Yeah.
No, I don't mean. And it's like, okay, keep backing yourself into this hole because guess what? I'm good. Clinical excellence is not a factor here. Mm-hmm. I put my shit on Instagram. So show me your stuff. I'll show you the x-rays. I'll show you the photos. Mm-hmm. Let me see your shit.
I was like, speed isn't necessarily a bad thing. You just need to find somebody who is fast because they are good.
Exactly.
Not, they're good because they're fast. Mm-hmm. No, they're
good
fast.
And fast.
They're fast because they have become good.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I agree. I don't think that I should be booked out for 15 minutes for a Brazilian simply because shit happens. Sometimes people are late. Uh-huh. I would prefer to have 30 minutes blocked out because if somebody shows up 10 minutes late, I still have 20 minutes to do a Brazilian. I can do that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I am fully capable of doing that.
That's why I schedule 60 minutes for a crown prep, knowing that I only need 30. Mm-hmm. It gives me the luxury of them being a little bit late. Traffic in Seattle sucks. Mm-hmm. It's worse than LA, really. Because LA has alternatives, Seattle doesn't. So our traffic sucks. It's not unusual to be a little bit tardy. Now, after 15 minutes, I'm not going to see you.
Yeah.
But, and some people, they're nervous. They don't get numb right away. Mm-hmm. I'm glad I have the full 60.
Yeah. Because, when people are nervous, I'm not an asshole. I don't torture people in my room. I torture assholes in my room. But you know what? That's usually deserved. But if I have somebody who is just nervous, I will give them the time that they need. I will take the setback in my schedule so that they are comfortable. Because if they are kind to me and we have created a bond or a relationship and we've got a good conversation flowing, I want them to come back.
Yeah.
So I will, if I'm just like, there are many times where I'm just like, hey, do you need a minute? Like, hey, do you want to take a second? Just kind of like stretch your legs a little bit. Cause I put them in butterfly position. This is not a comfortable position to put your people in for a long period of time.
I wouldn't want to do it.
It hurts your fucking hips.
So not a fan.
So a lot of times I'll be like, hey, do you want to stretch your legs for a second? I'm just going to mix my pot for a little bit. Yeah. Give you a minute.
Mm-hmm.
People appreciate that. Yeah. I'm good at what I do. Mm-hmm. I would rather have 30 minutes blocked out because sometimes there's also a lot of education that goes into it, and it's hard to get all of that education out within 15 minutes. I think the 15 minutes is dumb. However, nothing I can do about it.
Yeah, you're out of your control. Until you're your own boss, it's out of your control.
Exactly. And it's so annoying whenever people will talk to me like it's a problem that I inflicted on myself.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Like, they're like,
then go be your own boss. Start your own business.
Oh, yeah. Let me just do that real fast.
Yeah.
With the whole $20 that I have in my account. Like, awesome. Yeah. Can't wait. Yeah. I literally live paycheck to paycheck. I cannot afford to start my own business.
Yeah. People that don't run businesses have no idea how hard it is to run a business, how expensive it is. I mean, you got all these permits you have to do. You have rent. You got all the B&O taxes. You've got so much shit to do. It's not just, hey, I did this, pay me that. Mm-hmm. It's a mess. And that's why a lot of us don't want to be the boss anymore. So.
Yeah.
Anyway.
But there's nothing we can fucking do about it.
Nothing we can do.
I think the tipping culture in America is dumb.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing I can do about it.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, I am dependent on tips.
Yeah.
But that's just the reality of the situation.
That is the reality.
It's not, oh, I love being dependent on tips. Oh, pay me, give me money. I'm not going up to people and being like, give me money. This is the tipping culture in America. No, I'm saying if you're going to ask me to do this service for you, I want to be paid accordingly.
Enough, yeah.
For that to be worth it.
For sure, for sure. Well, we've been talking I've let you vent for quite a bit. I typically finish the show with a song, and I thought the best one for me to share with the audience is a song by Meatloaf. Are you familiar with Meatloaf?
A little bit.
Okay. Well, he sang this song, "I Would Do Anything for Love, But I Won't Do That." So for Bianca Timmerman, it's Lance Timmerman. Peace.
Peace.
from her. Some days it don't come at all, and these are the days that never end. And some nights you're breathing fire, and some nights you're carved in ice. Some nights you're like nothing I've ever seen before. Will again. Maybe I'm crazy. Oh, it's crazy and it's true. I know you can save me. No one else can save me now but you. As long as the planets are turning, as long as the stars are burning, as long as your dreams are burning, you better believe it, that I would do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. But I won't do that. No, I won't do that. I would do anything for love, anything you've been dreaming of. But I just won't do that. I would do anything for love, anything you've been dreaming of. But I just won't do that. And some days I pray for silence, and some days I pray for soul. Some days I just pray to the god of sex and drums and rock and roll. And maybe I'm lonely for a while, if I had to be. That's just one and only, one and only promise I can keep. As long as the wheels are turning, as long as the fires are burning, as long as your dreams are burning too.
And we're